Isaiah Firebrace will sing for Australia at Eurovision 2017. He has got the fire, he has a smooth, silky voice, and he has a very radio-friendly song. Let's talk about it. Yes, X Factor winner Isaiah, I don't know how to say it, but he slays. He is here, he is ready for Eurovision. You guys, when I heard this song, I hadn't actually looked at his face, and then I found out he was 17 years old. It blew my mind. The voice mixes, this is gonna sound strange, it's like Barry White meets Alicia Keys, if that's possible. It's so full and rich and powerful, and it doesn't sound 17. It sounds, you know, seasoned. It sounds 45, 50. This is all very positive. And he's connecting with the lyrics of his song. You know, there's a lot of emotion going on here. If you read the lyrics, I can tell by your eyes you want more than this, but can we be much more beyond these sheets? No, I don't want to mess with your head. Now, he's a little young to be rolling around those sheets, so I'm hoping that someone else wrote this, and they did. But what I'm trying to say is he is connecting, he is emoting, and from that perspective, it's very positive. Chris.
Yeah, I find him a lot like James Bay and sort of similar performers like that. He has quite a good, like, unique tone to his voice. He doesn't sound like that kind of, like, generic piano-playing person. He's got a nice tone. He's obviously done well on the X Factor. He had Guy Sebastian on the series that he won. He's working with Jessica Mauboy. He's doing touring, so I think he'll definitely be well-prepared for Eurovision. And I wonder whether it'll be not until Eurovision that we really start to get this song, because that's happened before, particularly with Dami Eam. I kind of feel like it's good average. Like, I don't massively remember it. It takes me to listen to it before I'm like, oh, yeah, this is Australia's song. And it's just kind of very much middle of the road for me right now. It's going to need a great live performance for it to jump up. And Australia could definitely do that, and he could definitely do that. But at the moment, it just feels like there are some other songs that have kind of usurped and stolen Australia's thunder. And particularly in that semi-final, like, there's a couple of other male singers who are doing kind of ballad songs. And, you know, when he's up against the likes of Blanche, and if Nano gets sent from Sweden, you don't know what's going to happen. They'll qualify, but this doesn't seem like it's going to do anywhere near as well as Australia have done. Right now, maybe that will change, but right now I don't have as good a feeling about it.
I agree with that. I think it is a good song. I do like it, and Isaiah, I think he has a good voice from what I've heard from him, and yeah, it sounds really good, especially the studio version. But it's not as good as the best songs that they were sending. Those two, I really loved it. They were really good, and especially on stage, it looked also amazing. And with this song, when I heard it the first time, I thought, ah, okay, well, yeah, it sounds good, but it's a little bit boring. And it's not just because it's a ballad, because it's not really a ballad. It's a bit more than that, but they can be really great, absolutely. But I feel like something is missing, and even though the voice sounds really good, especially for a 17-year-old, but something is missing in this song. And now that I've heard it a few times, it is growing on me. So it's getting better. And maybe like in a few days, I'll say like, oh yeah, this is in my top now. I absolutely love it. But for now, no. And yeah, it's just, I kind of forget about the song. I do know that I do like it, but I forget it. So when you're asking me like, oh, which are the songs that you do like this year? There's no way that I will mention Australia. So that's kind of the problem that we're having at the moment. So I hope that there will be something going on when he is on stage, that the staging will be good and his voice will be really good live, just so that I will remember it. But yeah, for Australia, I feel like I'm a little bit disappointed. Yeah, they just, maybe we're just really spoiled. They showed us like really good singers, really good entries and everything. So I think I'm just waving like a little breath at the moment. With any other country, I would be really happy if they were sending this. But yeah, like I said, it's not bad at all. It's good. It is good. They will go to the final. Yeah, I'm pretty sure about that. But the top five position, I'm not sure if they will reach it this time.
Yeah, I pity anyone who has to follow Dami Eam, because that, to me, is one of the best Eurovision acts of all time ever, staging, vocals, song, the total package. So I was always going to be slightly let down this year by whoever sang. What I like about Isaiah is that, you know, he has indigenous roots, for instance. They're showing a different flavor. You know, I like what he represents. I like that some people are criticizing them for drawing on reality TV shows again, but I'm sorry, what's wrong with that? Eurovision's a populist show. These shows are popular shows for the people, chosen by people. It shows that people already love him and that the broadcaster isn't, you know, operating behind a curtain. It's drawing from what people already like, and that's fantastic. The song does let me down a little. Before we did this video, I had to re-listen to it, and I was actually listening to his first single. What is it called? I Gotta...
Gotta Be You.
Be something.
Yes. Something like that. It's Gotta Be You, right. And I wasn't sure if it was actually his Eurovision song or not, because it sounded similar to me. And the problem is that this song just doesn't stand out. The hook isn't very memorable. And right now I would struggle to hum it. And I've listened to all the Eurovision songs like 50 times. I cannot remember it. I just remember that I really like his voice. I really like the quality. And I think that live it will elevate. With Dami Eam, Chris, you and I filmed the reaction video last year around this time, and we were kind of lukewarm. And I remember I wanted to be very positive, but we were a little lukewarm. And then Denise, you and I were together when we saw it live for the first time, yes. And we were both like, you know, doing like this. And it never died. So you can never rule Australia out, because they know how to put on a show. So I'm staying positive. I think the main issue for all of us, though, is this was released at the same time as Blanche's City Lights, and Blanche from Belgium has, of course, shot to number two in the odds, and the hype of that, the love of that, the enthusiasm is kind of clouding our judgment of everything else. That's not Australia's fault. That's just circumstances.
I think it's really unfortunate and unfair of people to criticize them for choosing an X Factor act when Dami Eam was the X Factor act. Yes. And fair enough, you've gone to that well twice now. Who cares? So many countries are. The UK's entire selection was X Factor acts. Anya Neeson, beloved by so many fans, X Factor Australia winner. You can go
Belgium,
on.
The Voice.
Yeah, exactly. And it's crazy that people would criticise that. Oh. Australia do have lots of other talent, and maybe the Dami Eam thing was almost a negative for Australia in a way. A lot of people wanted the Veronicas to do it. And I think even SBS said, like, they had like discussions with bigger acts, but nobody quite wanted to follow Dami Eam. Completely understand why, she killed it. But yeah, it just feels so kind of there. And I do think that maybe isolated, when we hear the running order, maybe it'll flow really well. But I also do worry that, you know, if Slavko comes along with something and steals the show with his staging, and you put him anywhere near this, Australia could get overshadowed. It will need to be framed very well in the semi-final, I feel like, and being in the first half for this to... I have this weird thing that I don't think they'll qualify, but I'm sure they will. But maybe it's not a guaranteed cert, so...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but like you said, it's like following up Dami Eam, it's really hard, and it's really brave of him, a 17-year-old, that he's saying, you know what, I will be the one. I will be the one standing there and being here, like, for all of Europe, for the whole world, and singing that song. So it's really brave that he dares to do that. So that is really good when other famous singers don't even want that. And, like, yeah, that is from X Factor. I mean, come on, who cares where do you get those people from? I don't care. Absolutely not. If they can sing, then it's all fine by me. And if they have a great song. And he can sing. We know that. So it's all good by me. And, we'll just see what happens. But I feel like, yeah, good job that you even said yes to it. And it's a big chance. And if he will do great, I mean, who knows what will come out of this. But, Yeah, you will always have that problem that if someone is doing really well, like if you are the winning country and you will choose this song for, let's say, for Ukraine now, you'll always compare it, and it will always be worse than the song that won. It will always be like that. So, brave guy.
Yeah, and just to close out, two positives. First, when you're a 17-year-old guy competing at Eurovision, you're going to stand out. So that's going to be in his favor. People, let's put San Marino to the side. That was a horrible song. But people want to get behind the youthful, you know, upstart who's trying to make his way. The second point is that I don't think there's anyone else with his type of voice in this contest. Mm-hmm. Like, his type of voice really stands out. It's funny, him and Ellie, not Ellie, Blanche from Belgium are in the same register, but that's because she's real deep. But yeah, it's interesting. He has a unique voice, and I think it's going to serve him well. So, yeah, song okay, but him excellent. In any case, that's what we think. What do you think? Are you loving Australia's song? Do you think that it will grow live? Do you think that anyone could come close to Dami Eam? Let us know here on wiwibloggs.
And let's change things this time. First, you hit the like, and then you will hit the
subscribe button.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. We'll see you later.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. We'll be right back.